Waste. What to do with it? It's a worldwide problem that's mounting.
The city of Karachi alone produces 10,000 tons of waste every single day. Much of that is non-biodegradable and is burnt or goes to landfill. But one local environmentalist thinks she's found the answer.
Necessity is the mother of invention. When the two go together, when you have this creative spirit in you, well, this is what happens.
Nargis Latif trained as a botanist. She's dedicated her life to protecting the environment in Pakistan's most populated, overcrowded city, Karachi. Her project, Gulbahal, deals with two major problems for the modern world: reducing waste and an increasing need for housing. She's making homes from garbage.
It's modular, it's weatherproof, it's low cost, and it is put up in just a matter of hours. Hey presto, you have just empty land. Here, after say 4 or 5 hours, you have a two-storied house.
Gulbahal works in conjunction with local factories to collect clean waste they simply don't need anymore, ready shredded. Or from landfill sites, they collect crisp packets, biscuit wrappers, things we use every single day that can be reused.
It's total waste. That's why they bring it to us.
And you're making use of it?
Yes. You see this house, you see this bed, you see this chair.
The strips of clean or dirty waste are used to fill up large sacks to make bricks, as Latif calls them, which are then bound together to form structures like shelters and houses, making use of non-biodegradable waste and reducing damage to the environment.
This is clean, but this is filthy. You can collect this waste material, which otherwise would have gone into the seas, into the rivers, into the gutter lines. You can stop that. I mean, use stuff like this.
The Chandighars, or silver homes, were first used during a natural disaster years ago, delivered to hundreds of homeless people in the north of Pakistan.
And when the Sandy storm took place, I was really wishing I could meet somebody and, you know, send it abroad to you so that it could be used there. Because this is quick to put up. We put them up when the earthquake took place in 2005. When the floods took place a couple of years ago in the Punjab, and then recently in Sindh, then here in the neighborhood a fire took place, we put up 10 houses there.
And her solutions don't end there. She's literally building gardens in the sky, plants grown in plastic bags, and even modular swimming pools. It's a source of employment for a handful of people, but Nadeef hopes to scale up this project, working with local NGOs to provide housing, not just in natural disasters, but for Pakistan's rapidly growing population. Saima Mohsin, CNN, Karachi.